Hi, this is Catherine Rose. I'm with Board Game Geek here at Spiel 2019. I'm sitting here with Uli Blenneman from Spielworks, and he's here to talk about Throne of Allegoria. So, please tell me about the game.
Yeah, this is Spielworks' new release right here for the show, for Essen. It's a game by Robin Lees and Steve McKenzie, two British designers who live in Denmark. It's a game in typical Spielworks tradition, so you play between 90 to 120 minutes. It has six game turns, and there is a queen, Queen Gwendoline.
But lovely name.
Yeah, but she will die, unfortunately.
Uh-huh.
And we are in the realm of her, and we try to become the successor on throne. So we having a house here, so this would be the patron of House Antares, but these roles are individual, so you can...
So there's a bit of a replayability there. Too.
Exactly. So this would mean that this is your town board, and you start with a different values here. So the four
depending
is
on
here.
Who you're beginning
exactly,
as.
Yes. Exactly. And this, of course, has... Every player has this, so it's for 2 to 4 players. And you also have 5 guild cards, which are backprinted, so... English and German, which you later can play in here. So you have 2 spots to play them. And you also have your framework. So at the start of the game, you get claims cards, which are red here. During the game, you can get more claims cards with a blue symbol, but better make sure that you will fulfill them, because if you do not fulfill a
you
card...
You get negative points.
Negative points.
Yeah, as you can see here. And then again, you have the two languages on here.
Exactly.
Making it very...
Yes. At the start here, this is a meta level. It's always a royal decree at the start of the turn.
And this is every single one of these 6 rounds.
Yep. Absolutely. Yes. And if the queen is still living, then it would be that part. If she's already dead, this part would happen.
So she could die early on.
Yes, you never know. There are 12 cards, but just 6 rounds. And in addition to the 6 cards, you have 1 card where she is dying. And I should have it here, in here. The queen is dead.
I see.
Yeah. Also, you have an economic card, a traveling merchant card. So this gives you, at the start of the turn, some idea if this is now a turn where you should invest into economy. This
or
is actually
instead ignore that and focus more on your political game.
Absolutely, this is a pretty bad card, but there are others, of course. At the start of the turn, each player has 6 of
these really nice, beautiful, really nice and tactile pieces.
Yeah, bidding tokens, and you play them 1 at a time. There are 2 zeros, 2 ones, 1 2, and 1 special one with a star. And you place them on these 7 bidding tracks.
Ah, all right, so.
So it would be, yes, the first one, like you did, always in the left spot. And this is for 3 players, this is for 4 players.
And then
players.
Another player will come in and put something, and you don't know what they've actually bid until the...
Right, absolutely correct. You could also put in another one, up to 3, which it says...
And that could still easily be 2 zeros without them being aware of the fact that you're not actually bidding anything.
Yes, absolutely correct. This one I won't explain, it gives you some special powers, but this would be too long. Other stuff, you have some anarchy cubes, which you do not want to get, but it can happen. There is an Elms track. If you give money to the poor, you will advance here, which is very nice.
Becoming popular with the people is important, right?
Yes, right. And this is a diplomacy track. It also makes sense to advance here. And the 7 bidding tracks, they are connected to actions. So if I would be the only one or the winner who has the most points here for strength, for soldiers, I'm looking at this chart, 4 players, 3 players, 2 players, and give some and get some action points. And you see on the play 8, there are the actions for the various tracks. So this would be German, actually. This
English
is English again. And now I can do maybe 3 actions with soldiers. So it could be recruit. May I just remove this? And then you could put on your battlefield, this would be minor realm here, I could put in a soldier. I can also add workforce cards, which are appropriate. So this would be a soldier to advance on this track. the
numbers. To make you a little stronger in one year.
Exactly, yes.
There's lots of little things going on that all have a hand in advancing your political career,
yes.
basically, and winning that glorious new ruler spot,
yes,
right?
Basically, these are victory points. In the game, they are called influence points, and you get them for various actions. But it's not, definitely not, a bidding game. Of course, bidding, bluffing has its part, but you need to see, is it now a good time to invest in merchants and then bring in new merchants on the board and do the merchants' acts?
And so this
or,
is a whole balancing thing. What
yes.
should I focus on? Where should I spread myself thin with lots of different things, or should I focus on one?
Absolutely,
or perhaps that
right.
balance between the two.
And after six turns, you see who has the most influence points, which you can get from cards, for battles. Battles are also possible for an economic trade. And for some other ways, also for your guild cards, which you have on the table, and how far you have advanced on the track. So this would be right now 2 points for soldiers, 0 points for these two tracks, and this would be
negative
even minus
one, right?
a point. So you need to advance here as well.
And at the end of the six rounds, you then check all these things, and then
who has the most influence points
will be the new ruler.
Exactly.
Fantastic, thank you so much. That
You're
is
welcome.
Throne of Allegoria from Spielberg's.
Thank you so much.